Hallelujah. Truly, God is good.
Amen.
God is good. Amen. He's worthy of all of our praise. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. And, you know, I'm just thankful. Some people might have been worried a little bit. Pastor, you know, half the congregation will be gone, but that's all right.
Praise God.
Amen. But at 2 or 3.
Praise God.
Amen. Amen. I told him, I'm going to shout and praise him just like a 2 or 3 in the building.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Because God has been too good and too kind.
Glory to God.
Amen. For me to just sit down on him.
Amen.
Amen. Huh? This is about Christ.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
That's the way we should look at it.
Amen.
Amen. God blesses us. Amen. And he will bless us even more.
Amen.
If we just do what he say.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Some people want blessings, but they want to hold all everything tight. Can't get nothing in the hand, can't get nothing out.
I like that.
They want God's blessing. Well, just do what he say.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Give us a choice.
Yes,
we thank God for the choice.
Amen.
Yeah,
Lord.
Hmm?
Amen.
Amen. You increase each and every one of us.
Amen.
I tell people all the time, God is rich.
Amen.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
He made everything. He's rich. I shouldn't be poor.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
The old cattle's on 9,000 here. Why should I be poor?
Amen.
My father's rich.
Amen.
Amen. And that's where I look at it. We all should look at it like that.
Amen.
We all should look at it the same way.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And what he did for others, he'll do the same thing for each and every one of us.
Amen.
Amen. But sometimes we have to check ourselves.
All right.
Amen. We have to check ourselves. Maybe it's something we ain't doing right.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Amen. From the text that was read, we're talking about restore the joy of my salvation.
Yeah.
Talking about restoring the joy of my salvation.
Yeah.
This psalm begins with the announcement. Amen. Declaration that God had brought back the captivity of Jacob.
Mm-hmm.
That's where it starts. Amen. When we look at Psalms 85 and verse 1, beginning, it says that, Lord, you have been favorable to your land.
Mm-hmm.
You have brought back the captivity of Jacob. You have forgiven the iniquity of your people. You have covered all their sins. You have taken away all your wrath. You have turned from your fierceness of anger, of your anger. Ain't that good?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. You know they had been in captivity for 70 years. Amen. And God have brought them back to the land. The Lord had returned the children of Israel, amen, and that Judah, Jerusalem, but still something was missing. Something was missing. There wasn't a full spiritual restoration. Amen. Something was missing. In other words, they was living back in the homeland. Amen. They was going to church, and they was planting their crops, and they was having, everything was going well for them. They were doing good.
Yeah.
God has blessed them back
right.
in their homeland.
Uh-huh.
But they didn't have the Lord yeah. there with them.
My Lord.
They didn't have, hey man, you ever felt like something was missing in your life sometimes?
Yeah.
I know I have. It's just something not there. You know, you just don't feel strong. It's like the spirit is not with you. You ever felt alone sometime? Huh?
My Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And this is what they was feeling. They was back and things seemed to be doing good. They seemed to be doing well. Huh? Amen. But the Spirit of the Lord wasn't there. So the psalmist, he prayed to God. He said to God, restore. Verse 4. Restore to us the joy of our salvation. Amen. That's what he's saying. And he said, and cause your anger toward us to cease. Amen. In other words, amen, they just wasn't feeling God, just wasn't there. Amen. Even though he was blessing them, but he wasn't there. And look what the psalmist said. Will you be angry with us forever? Throughout all generations? Do you see that? Yes. Will you not return to us? Will you not revive us?
My Lord.
Amen. Revive us. Somebody ought to say, revive us, Lord.
Revive us, Lord.
Revive us, he said again.
Yes, Lord.
That your people may rejoice in you.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. You know, you can be doing well.
Yeah.
But something just not right.
All right.
Amen. So maybe we need to get on our knees like Simon and say, Lord, revive me.
Yeah, Lord.
Hallelujah. Restore unto me, Lord, the joy of my salvation.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. Then he said, please let us experience your mercy.
Yes.
Let us experience your mercy. And we know what Ecclesiastes said. Great is thy faithfulness.
Right.
New mercies every day. God will bless us every day. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
His affirmation is that God will speak.
Yes.
Did y'all see that?
Yes.
Amen. God will speak. That's verse 8 where we read. Mm-hmm. Amen. But he will speak peace to his people.
Yes.
And to his saints.
Amen.
But then let them not turn back to their father.
My Lord.
Huh?
Yeah.
In other words, God gonna bless you.
Keep going back now.
But don't go back to the same mess you was in.
All right.
You know, some people do that.
Amen.
Soon as God blesses them,
my Lord,
they go right back to doing what they used to do.
All right now.
Amen.
Hey, man, I had old balls, I told you one time. Hey, man, he had ended up with a colossal bag on his side, had a massive heart attack. He was a terrible man. But after he had this massive heart attack and stopped coming back, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He comes to the job and he was the nicest man he ever wanted to be.
My Lord.
Huh?
My Lord.
They had to help him, you know. He had to carry that thing. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
My Lord.
He was all right. And as soon as the Lord blessed him.
My Lord.
Amen. And he had to carry that no more. And he was back strong again.
Mm-hmm.
Back working again. It seemed like he started inching back.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Creeping back into the same old way.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Amen. And the psalmist said to his people, to his saints, but let them not turn back.
That's right.
To folly. Let them not turn back.
Yes.
When God bless you, don't go back to doing the same thing you was doing.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Amen. Telling the same old lies.
Yeah.
Same old stuff.
Yeah.
And some people like to lie because it piques people's attention.
Yeah.
Hey, amen. It grabs their attention. So they just like, make, you know, they make them feel good.
Yeah.
Hey, amen. I don't want to talk about my brother. Not the one you know. Yes, indeed. I am one just like that. Just could love to hear himself talk. Amen. It said, for if they do return back to their folly, the same thing they used to do, his wrath will fall upon them again. And their peace will be invaded again. Those who will enjoy communion with God must deny themselves. Take up your cross and follow him.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. That's what I'm saying again.
Mm-hmm.
Those who would enjoy communion with God must deny themselves and pick up their cross. Not his cross. Pick up your cross and follow him.
Yeah, Lord.
And avoid all that would grieve the Holy Spirit. Avoid all that would grieve the Holy Spirit. How do I grieve the Holy Spirit? When I go back to the old man, I grieve the Holy Spirit. Amen. How do I grieve the Holy Spirit when I put myself on a pedestal and put everybody else under me? Put them down. How do I grieve the Holy Spirit when filthy communication come out of my mouth? I grieve the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Go with me to Ephesians. Amen. And we have Ephesians chapter 4. Amen. And it says in 30, verse 30, and do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Amen. And then look what it says. Let all bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor, evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. So you want to ask, how do you grieve the Holy Spirit? There you go. And be kind to one another. Tenderhearted. Forgiving one another. Even as God in Christ have forgiven you. Amen. He continued with his belief in God in verse 9. Surely his salvation is near to those who fear him. Amen. James said, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Amen. Come with clean hands and a clean heart.
Lord.
Amen. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
God will draw near to you. Amen. God will be right there with you. Amen. But you got to come right.
Amen.
You got to come right. You stay in the will of God. He will never leave you nor forsake you.
Lord.
You can depend on God. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
You can depend on him.
Yes.
When you can't depend on no one else, you can depend on God.
Yes.
Amen. Verse 10 in our text says, mercy and truth have met together.
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Yeah,
mercy come hand in hand with truth. To fulfill the faithful promise of God.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Mercy and truth have come together. God can shower his steadfast love on his people.
Lord.
Because all the claims of truth were fulfilled. It was met by the Lord. Jesus Christ on the cross. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
He was the truth.
Yes.
Amen. And because, hallelujah, I'm in Christ, amen, then I can say it's all been taken care of through Christ.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. We are free.
Yes.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Because of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Amen. And if Jesus sets you free,
yes,
you are free. Can I get a witness? If he set you free, you're free. Indeed. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness?
Thank you, Lord.
In the same sense, righteousness and peace have kissed, it says.
Yes.
Because justice was paid by Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. He took my place.
Thank
Amen.
Lord.
Substitutionary death.
Yes.
He took my place. And because he died, I can have peace.
Yeah, Lord.
Can I get a witness?
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Peace.
Yeah.
That's a path that all understand.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. Some people don't understand the joy and the peace that Christians have.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. But I tell them that it's because of Christ.
Yeah.
Amen. And If you're having a problem and you're going through a different situation, give it to God.
Yes.
Amen. Turn your life over to Jesus.
Yeah, Lord.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
It's a sad thing when the Spirit of God has left you.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. And we hear the psalmist say, restore.
Yes.
Restore, Lord, to us the joy of our salvation.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to feel your presence. He said, revive us again.
Yes.
The story goes on. Hallelujah. The children of Israel were deported to Babylon. They were sad. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. If you want to follow me, you can go to Psalms 137. Amen. Hallelujah. And they were deported to Babylon. They were sad. They had no joy.
My Lord.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
The soldiers heard them. They were great singers.
Uh-huh.
Can I get a witness?
Yes.
They heard that the people of Israel were great musicians.
My Lord.
Amen. And the soldiers asked the children of Israel, say, how about singing us one of your songs?
Yeah.
Amen. We heard that you're great singers and great musicians.
Yeah.
How about singing us a song?
Yeah.
Amen. But you hear what the psalmist says here in 137.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It says, by the river of Babylon,
mm-hmm.
there we sat down, yet we wept.
Uh-huh.
When we remember Zion, amen. We hung our hearts upon the willow in the midst of it.
My Lord.
For there those who carried us away
mm-hmm.
captive asked us to sing a song. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
And those who plundered us, in other words, hallelujah, they stole from Israel.
My Lord.
Amen. Took stuff from their house. Amen. You know how it is when you're a slave, they treat you any kind of way.
Yeah,
amen. But still, after treating them any kind of way, amen, they asked them still, I want you to sing us a song.
Yeah.
Amen. And I hear the children of Israel say, how can we sing a song?
Yeah.
Amen. When you're stealing from us.
Yeah.
Amen. How can we sing a song?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. When you're whipping us.
Yeah.
Amen. Taking everything that God has blessed us with.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We cannot sing a song in a strange land.
Yeah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Amen. And then you see in this text, he said, you laughed at us.
Uh-huh.
Amen. They were laughing at him.
Uh-huh.
Amen. But I come to tell you, hallelujah, sometime when you're down,
yeah.
amen, and people treat you bad, amen. Don't let them keep you down.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Hold your head up.
Yeah.
Amen. And sing a song anyhow.
Yeah.
Amen. Sometime our song is for us.
Yeah.
Amen. Not for them.
Yeah. Yeah, Lord.
They were sad. Hallelujah. They didn't want to be there.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
When God brought them back, the Spirit of the Lord
uh-huh.
was not with them. But the psalmist had confidence in God.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
He said, Lord, restore to us
yes.
the joy of our salvation.
Yeah, Lord.
Amen. And he said, revive us again.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Amen. And when we go to verse 12, he said, yes, the Lord will forgive. Hallelujah. What is good? Can I get a witness? And righteousness will be before him. He will bless your land. Can I get a witness? He will, hallelujah, bless your house. Amen. God will bless your finances. Hallelujah. Yes, he will. Hallelujah. He will bless you. Amen. If you don't turn back to your valley,
yeah.
amen, just keep straight on and keep working for God,
yeah.
amen, and he will bless you.
Yeah.
Yes, the Lord will give you what is good. Can I get a witness?
Amen.
And our land will yield its increase. Hallelujah. Do your Bible say that? It said righteousness will go before him. Amen. And shall make his footstep our pathway. Amen. And I'm so glad, amen, that trouble don't last always. I'm glad that if I put it in God's hands, amen, hallelujah, he will multiply whatever I do. Amen, hallelujah. Amen. If you don't feel it, if you don't have it, amen, if something seems like it's not there, just ask God to revive us again. Amen. God, I need your presence. I need to feel your presence. Amen. Some people just going through the motion.
All right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. But I want to feel his presence. Hallelujah. So because I know in the midst of a storm, amen, if I got Jesus. Amen. I'm gonna make it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Ain't God good?
Yeah.
Amen. Praise him. Do you receive it today?
Amen.
Did you receive the word? Restore unto me the joy of my salvation.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. I want to feel good again.
Amen.
Amen. God is a good God.
Yes.
God is a good God. Amen.